exalted in throne above all other gods. We bow down before you because you are the great I am. There is none before you, there will be none after you, and there is none right now, O God. Father God, eternal King, Rock of ages, we thank you that from age to age you stay the same. You neither grow weary, you never grow old. Father, you are the same yesterday, you are the same today, and you are the same tomorrow. We thank you, my God, that my love, nothing can dethrone you, because no one puts you where you are. I thank you, Father. Now, Lord, today as you visited us with your goodness, Lord, as we begin to pray and intercede, we want to thank you that you will answer us by fire. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Isaiah 43. But now thus says the Lord, who created you, O Pastor Austin.
Amen.
And he who formed you, O Pastor Austin.
Amen.
Fear not, for I have redeemed you.
Amen.
I have what?
Redeemed you.
I have what?
Redeemed you.
You are mine. Tell your neighbor, you are mine.
You are mine.
Don't be that today.
You are mine. God is taking you today as his own special possession. He is saying, you are mine.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
You are mine.
Yes.
You don't belong to darkness. You don't belong to your own family.
Amen.
You belong to me. You are mine.
Yes.
I am your father. I am your husband. I am your friend. Sticks closer than a brother. You are mine.
Yes. Yes.
Today, just thank God because he's saying you are mine.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Israel sang that song. He says, I am a friend of God. No, 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 I don't be a friend of God. I want to be his son.
Yes.
Because there's privileges of being a son of God.
Amen.
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 Say, you are mine.
You are mine.
You are my God.
You are my God.
And the apostle said, I have called you by name.
Mm.
When you pass through the waters, I will be with you.
Yes.
When you go through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned,
yes,
nor shall the flame scorch you.
Yes.
I've come to speak to someone today, just to pray for someone who is going through the fire. And I've come to say it's time for you to release your faith. Because your faith is what quenches the fire. Amen.
Amen.
1 Peter, open to me, 1 Peter 1:7. Someone is going through a fiery trial, and today is the end of that trial. Someone is going through a fiery trial. Today is the what? End of that fiery trial. Whether they're present or not present. The Bible says, 1 Peter 1:7 says that the genuineness of your faith being much more precious than gold that perishes, though it is tested by fire, may be found to be praise, honor, and glory at the revelation of Jesus. You are being tested by what? By fire. And there is glory that's going to come out of your life. There is glory that's going to what? Come out of your life. Psalm 43 says, when I walk through the fire. Now I'm saying this guy is not serious. I would run through fire. Even in rituals, they run through fires. But God is saying you will walk. Why should you walk? Because your enemies ought to see that you won't get burnt. Amen.
Amen.
You have to run through fire, sir. Amen. The rituals, they run through fires. But this one is walking. Though you walk through fire, and God today is saying, go through it, you will come out of it. It won't burn you.
Amen.
Walk through it. Walk through the words, the hard words. Walk through the hard mocking. Walk through this hard period. It is hot, but you won't be burnt. Amen? Because that's the only way God is going to show you off to your enemies. Daniel was thrown in a den of lions and left overnight. He sat down and they used the lions as his cushions and blankets. Amen? Go through it. Tell your neighbor, go through it.
Go through it.
Say, Father,
Father,
every fiery dart,
every
fiery arrow,
every
fiery word,
every
fiery curse sent against my life, sent against this ministry, sent against my family, sent against my finances, by the shield of faith, I quench you right now. By the water of heaven, I put you up right now. By the
I want to acknowledge him. house his arm over this part of London too, to bring bread of life on this side. And I also want to acknowledge Pastor Austin for an awesome work that he's doing. And I think you should clap your hands. Doing church is one of the most challenging things. I tell people, if you're not, and you call yourself into it, you invite things that you cannot handle in your life. If you're not called into this thing, and you call yourself, your mustache will move from here to there. This thing is a challenging thing. It is the journey of taking people from where they are and helping them get to where God wants them to be. If you want to know anything about people, ask Moses. He will tell you a lot about people. All he wanted to do in life was to fulfill his call. He didn't even want it. He gave all kinds of excuses, but God said, no, you are the one that I'm going to use to take these people from here to a land flowing with milk and honey. And Moses had a lot of challenges. But I say let us acknowledge Pastor Austin, because I want to say that there are a lot of things he grapples with, and there are a lot of things that by necessity he deals with because of his heart for you. He wants to take you from one place to a better place. Amen. And I think he's done well so far. He's done very well so far. The man is not only bigger than me physically, but he has shown that he is bigger in passion, he is bigger in belief, and he is bigger in tenacity,
amen.
You know, to take you from where you are to where God wants to take you.
Yes.
I mean, I see this is my first time of coming here. I see this as a graduation.
Amen.
You know, it's a journey.
All right.
Yes. God takes you from one place to another.
Yes.
This is not your destination. This is only a stepping stone into another place that God is doing. And you see, you should not look at things based on the outward. You should look at things based on the destination. Every journey becomes exciting when you look at the destination. If you look at the location you are at presently, you may not enjoy the journey. But I encourage you, enjoy the journey, because you're going to a greater and a bigger place.